Hello friends, in this audio video tutorial, we are going to study cross drainage work. What is meant by cross drainage work and what are their types and why it is necessary. So, a definition, a cross drainage work is a structure carrying the discharge from the natural stream across the canal, intercepting the stream. Canal comes across obstruction like river, natural drain and other canal. The various types of structure that are built to carry the canal water across the above mentioned obstruction or vice versa are called cross drainage work. So it is generally a very costly item and should be avoided by first diverting one stream into another. Second, by changing the alignment of the canal so that it crosses below the junction of the two streams. Then types of cross drainage works. Depending upon the levels and discharge, it may be of the following types. Cross drainage work carrying canal across the drainage. The structures that fall under this category are an aqueduct and siphon aqueduct. So aqueduct, when high flood level, HFL is high flood level of the drain, is sufficiently below the bottom of the canal such that the drainage water flows freely under gravity, the structure is known as aqueduct. In this, canal water is carried across the drainage in a trough supported on piers. Second, bridge carrying water. Third, provided when sufficient level difference is available between the canal and natural, and canal bed is sufficiently higher than high flood level. So these are the crossing works, aqueducts. So here you will see the drains, also the river. Then siphon aqueduct. In case of siphon aqueduct, the high flood level of the drain is much higher above the canal bed and water runs under siphonic action through the aqueduct barrel. The drain bed is generally depressed and provided with pussy floor on the upstream side, and the drainage bed may be joined to the pakka floor either by vertical drop or by glacis of 3:1. The downstream rising slope should not be steeper than 5:1. When the canal is passed over the drain, the canal remains open for inspection throughout and damage caused by flood is rare. However, during heavy flood, the foundations are susceptible to scour or the waterway of drain may get chopped due to debris and trees, etc. So here cross drainage work carrying drainage over canal. Then super passages. In super passages, the hydraulic structure in which the drainage is passing over the irrigation canal, is called as a super passage. A super passage is similar to an aqueduct, except in this case the drain is over the canal. In aqueduct, drain is below the canal. Then canal siphon. If two canals cross each other and one of the canal is siphoned under the other, then the hydraulic structure at crossing is called canal siphon. For example, lower Jhelum canal is siphoned under the Rasul Qadirabad link canal and the crossing structure is called LJC siphon. Selection of suitable site for cross drainage work. The factors which affect the selection of suitable type of cross drainage work depends upon relative bed level and water level of the canal and drainage, size of the canal and drainage. Then the following considerations are also important as far as the selection of site for cross drainage works is concerned. First, when the bed level of the canal is much above the high flood level of the drainage, an aqueduct is the obvious choice. When the bed level of the drain is well above FSL of canal, super passage is provided. Another, selection of suitable site for cross drainage work. So these are the some continuation factors. The necessary headway between the canal bed level and drainage, HFL can be increased by shifting the crossing to the downstream of drainage. If, however, it is not possible to change the canal element, a siphon aqueduct may be provided. Then, factors which influence the choice or selection of cross drainage work. These are some factors. First is suitable canal alignment, suitable soil available for the bank connection, nature of available foundation, availability of funds also. It is also an important factor, availability of fund. Then the permissible head loss in canal. Head loss in canal is also an important factor. The consideration which governs the choice, they are as below. And whatever I have explained earlier, these are the some considerations which govern the choice of between aqueduct and siphon aqueduct. Based on these factors, your choice depends. Then compared to an aqueduct, a super passage is inferior and should be avoided whenever possible. Siphon aqueduct is preferred over siphon unless large drop in drainage bed is required. Then this is the aqueduct, so high flood level, FSL, then this is canal, this is also high flood level, and this is the drain. Drain is below the canal, so this is culvert length. As you know, the culvert is also cross drainage work structure. Then this is another aqueduct, then this is siphon aqueduct, this is super passage. Then aqueduct with unobstructed canal. So aqueduct with unobstructed canal, this is a cross section, this is L section of this aqueduct with unobstructed canal. Means for aqueduct there will be no obstruction from canal. Then inlet. The inlet is constructed to admit the flow of small perennial streams into the channel. The bank of channel is cut open and the sides and bed protected by pitching. If bed of the stream is slightly at higher level than the bed of the canal, the stream may be admitted to the channel through inlet provided with drop. For very small streams, inlet may be mere pipe laid in the bank of the canal. Then outlet. Its job is reverse to that of the inlet. Outlet means its job is reverse to that of the inlet. It is the opposite to the inlet. It is an arrangement in the bank of channel to discharge out the surplus water from the channel. The outlet becomes necessary when discharge admitted into the channel by an inlet raises the water level above the maximum water level of the channel. If the level of water level in the channel raises above the maximum water level permissible, then outlet comes into picture. The outlet is similar in action to surplus escape and is provided at suitable site where surplus water can be easily discharged into the site well. Then selection of site for cross drainage work, again same factors I have explained. Then the type of cross drainage work should be carefully decided with reference to which type of cross drainage work. That it may be a siphon aqueduct, it may be aqueduct, it may be a super passage. So on which factor it depends? Selection depends on the bed level. The second factor is discharge of the canal and drainage. Then overall cheapness of the construction, that is the availability of fund. It also most important factor which affects the selection. Then selection of suitable type of cross drainage work. While making selection of suitable type of cross drainage work, following points are necessary to consider. First, if the bed level of the canal is sufficiently above high flood level of the drainage, then if bed level of drain is sufficiently above the FSL, if headway below the canal bed level and the above HF high flood level, then if canal bed is lower than the HFL of the drainage, if canal and drainage cross each other more or less at same level crossing may be preferred. If we want to change the type of cross drainage work, it can be done by shifting the crossing point either downstream or upstream side. By doing so, relative heights of the each work can be changed, and hence type of work can be changed. So crossing, selection of crossing of these two, canal and drainage, is very much important. This is what the summary point for this lecture. Thank you. And then again some major points if you keep in your mind for selection of suitable type of cross drainage work is the relative level of discharge, then performance, provision of road, size of drainage, cost of earthwork, foundation, materials of construction, cost of construction, permissible loss head, subsoil water table, canal alignment. So thank you for watching the video. If you like it, please do share it and subscribe the channel. Thank you.